Hi, I'm Rachel Greninger with Red Carpet Report, and tonight we're at the 17th Annual Women's Image Awards honoring women in media. Hi, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Hi, my name's Rachel.
Hi, Rachel.
So tell me a little bit about what makes you excited to be here this evening at an event for women by women.
Well, a couple of us from SAG-AFTRA wanted to come because we're all involved in the diversity committees there. And I'm in the women's committee, and I'm in the LGBT committee. My friend Jody heads up the EOC over there. And I don't know if you know, but SAG released this great statement today about it, which I wanted to have on my phone and read because it was so beautifully put, that it's not just about color, but it's about gender identity and age. And you know, there's so many things that we're not really seeing on the screen, and that we are encouraging people who make films and the people who are behind films to try to bring. And of course, for me, it would be about age and gender, but you know, there are a lot of things, particularly women. There was a period in time in film where we really saw films centered on women's issues, and now it's all about, you know,
the biggest.
The man.
Yeah.
It's all about, oh, the man is going through trauma, the man. And we used to see, you know, Meryl Streep and all of these women, and, you know, the films centered around them. And I don't see films that I want to go see because there are no films that are about me. And they're all men. And I watch these films and I'm like,
there's a disconnect. I mean, I think that's...
Do they think women aren't going to films? Do they think that we're not paying to see films? Do they think we're not buying films? Do they think we're not watching? There are more women than there are men. So I don't understand what's going on behind that. That they think we don't exist. We don't want to watch. That we don't want to see stories about ourselves.
Well, it's amazing too, because I feel like with women, like, you see sort of like this small, like fetal, almost like youngness, like you see them being party animals in college girls, and then you see them, and then there's this huge gap where you just don't see them from the time they're like 30 to 50, and it's like, well, these
really
are, this is reality.
Then, oh, they're the girlfriend.
Exactly.
You know, it's something it's just ridiculous.
Well, especially because women are so, especially now in society, like millennial women are like the younger people that are coming up, we're so strong.
We're so interesting. The thing is that there are so many interesting stories, which, you know, you see Girls on HBO, and you see, it's fascinating, and also because they're being so truthful, and what is so fascinating about that show is that it's so truthful, and you know, it's ugly, it's pretty, it's like, what we're not seeing any of that in film. And, you know, if you do see a woman, it's kind of idealized, or they're, you know, a victim, or they're, you know.
I see a lot with, like, when they do these scenes where the guy and the girl wake up the next morning and the girl's already wearing makeup, and I think that's not reality. Like, why are you doing that? Like, I get that it's a film and that's what we're doing, but at the same time, you're also making it harder for me to relate to that, because that's not my life. Like, I wear no makeup at home, ever. Like, I only put it on when I have to, and so it's difficult because it's not relatable for me. And so you're dealing with that.
You're dealing with HD, and you're dealing with, so you can see they're wearing makeup because you see the HD. So you're like, and now they have, what is this, 4D? I mean, my son, so I got to have a 4D television, and I'm like, what is that?
Isn't that just going outside? Like, isn't that what that would be?
It's making my life as an actor even worse. You're going to go even closer and see more pores.
My producer was just zooming in on my face. I was like, don't. I need you to not do that.
We really need to see all the
There's
pores.
There's no need for this.
No.
No one wants to get this close to this. Let's be honest.
I mean, okay.
Wait. Unless you're like my dog or like a love of my life or something.
But, you know, we say all these things. There's all of this talk about it. There's actually legal proceedings going on about it. But does it change? I don't know.
Hopefully the conversation will get people to realize something about it.
They're so scared to put any money behind anything that's not a franchise, that's not already a successful
book, or a reboot.
It's not a, you know, something that's already been done and they're going to redo it again. They're spending $300 million on films now. They're spending so much money that they're afraid to put anything forward unless, you know, it's a guaranteed win. To me, we've got to go back to, well, you know, you have Fox Searchlight doing smaller films. There needs to be more investment in that. Yeah.
Well, you're doing definitely the best thing you can do is being here and talking about it and everything.
I am awarding all of these really exciting projects. I mean, I looked at the list of things that were being honored, and it was just so exciting.
Hunting Ground is one of the most amazing. It's so hard to watch. It's so hard to watch, but it's so relevant. That's why.
And I never did find out how many people watched it, because the night that I was watching it, I was like, I wonder what the ratings are.
The producers actually said that if anybody on a college campus wants to watch it and they can't get a hold of it, to contact their Facebook page and they'll get it in their hands because they think it's that important. I agree.
I was just really hoping that so many people were seeing this. You know, I don't know how many did.
I want to get it in the hands of more people. I know a lot of people still don't know about it, and that's one of the hardest things, I think, especially dealing with young women and just women in general.
Repeating it.
Yeah, right.
On whatever.
Again and again, hopefully.
Because it's really important that it gets seen. And you know, I kept wondering, for me, because I have sons. You know, I have two sons, sweet boys. But, you know, I kept thinking, what is going on with these boys? How are they being raised? You know, why are they being raised in such a way that they are not getting it? That they're not getting, you know, that no means no. Or that no means no even in the process of maybe something that's going on. They're not being raised to be gentlemen. You know, I don't understand that. You know, some of the behavior that's been going on outside fraternity houses, you know, where the fraternity guys are yelling these things outside. What
were those signs that they're putting?
Who are these boys?
I think it's
their parents. And how are their parents? What kind of parents are raising boys that do this kind of stuff? You know,
that's a scary thing, especially because you are a mother of boys. Like, you're coming from a perspective of, never in a million years would I ever allow this from my child. How is anybody?
Neither of my boys do anything like that. And I know they wouldn't. You know, so I just...
You know, small steps in the right direction, I guess, right?
And I mean, don't even know if they knew boys that might do something like that. Maybe they did. But, you know, I kind of... Sometimes when I was watching the show, I was thinking, did they know, or any of the boys that they knew at Brentwood or whatever, would they ever be like this or do something like the kinds of, you know,
things,
not necessarily the rape, but the kinds of group, you know, I don't know. It's so shocking.
That it's, yeah, absolutely. Thank you so much,
anyway,
and congratulations. Yeah, no,
sorry.
It's good. Talking is good. Sharing ideas.
So nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
And thank you for doing this.
Yeah, no, it's important. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like what you've seen here, go ahead and hit like, subscribe, and in the comments below, tell me what woman inspires you the most.